Well, it seemed to me that 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Rosie, thank God you come. This is the end of the Alamo Music Corporation. Carl Bernie's going to the Army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting a resignation.
What?
Just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of love.
Well, Rosie, you can't not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? A little wet one to take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Break it in half.
You're 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin.
I am not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 till tomorrow. Water?
It's no use, Albert. My mind's made up. I've been with Amelou 8 years now, and as you well know, I've been much more than just a secretary to you.
Rosie, those are moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness and the office, I put in a good 90-hour week.
I get it. You want a raise.
Wrong. You know what I want.
Rosie, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
Maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop poor Lou either. He loved you, Rose.
I loved Lou too. Sure, he was warm, he was loyal, he was lovable, but he died 6 years ago. And besides, he was a wild-haired terrier. Anyhow, I don't want a part of the company. This is something much more important.
Rose, I already told you, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Birdie's going into the Army. I've quit. There's nothing you can do but give up the business and go back
Rosie, to Rosie, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad Birdie has a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance.
Can't we would know what life means? Come and
Stay with me. Help me pay for Kara's guarantee. And as soon as I'm out the red, I'll dissolve the company and go back to the academic life.
Albert, you're on.
Of course, it may take a while. But by 1972, Orson definitely is, well, what's that?
Something that's going to push that date up a few years. Pick a name.
Pick what name? What are you talking about?
All right, I'll do it for you. McAfee. Kim McAfee. Age 15, president and recording secretary, Conrad Birdie fan club, number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Mary, would you get me Sweet Apple, Ohio? The numbers? Capital 7-8820. And call me right back.
Now, wait a minute. Who's Kim, whatever her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is just gonna send you back to college with the biggest hit song this business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
I never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie on his way into the big cold army for 2 long years, and he gives that one kiss to one of his fans chosen at random from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. We cut the record here in New York.
Take Conrad, that greasy bongo playing car thief, to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
Release the record. Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college the rest of your life.
Rose, it's wonderful. And I promise you, as soon as things are settled, it'll be just the two of us. In perfect bliss, I'll go back to teaching English and bliss kiss that rhyme. I wonder if anyone's ever used it before. Oh, what difference does it make? It'll be great for the time. Oh, one last kiss. What is it into Frisco? No, that's too clinical.
Keep trying and coming right back.
Go inside! The operator says she's been trying to get through for nearly 3 quarters.
I'll take it down there.
She says it's long distance, and I can't imagine who... What did you say?
I said, thank you, Doris. Oh, there's no need to look so upset. It's a motto to call your mother by her first name. It makes a mother and daughter more like pals.
And your father?
I'll call him Harry, naturally. Yes, this is she. By the way, Doris, I think Harry took the news about Hugh and I awfully well. Don't you, Doris?
I don't know. Yesterday I was a mother. Today I'm a pal. Are you sure you wouldn't like to call me Mom?
I'm sorry, but times are changing. And you've got to go along with them, or be left behind with the old folks. Conrad Birdie? Going to kiss me? Doris! Mother! Mommy!
Baby, what's wrong? What is it?
It's Conrad Birdie, Mommy! He's going to kiss me!
That's nice, dear. Now why don't you just rest your head on Mommy's shoulder?
But you don't understand! It's Conrad Birdie! He's coming here to be able to kiss me goodbye! Oh, Mommy!
Track 12, you want to see Conrad before he comes?
No,
Oh boy, would you get that stuff down to track 12 on the double? Rosie, what are you doing here?
Getting our things down to the station without any help from you, Albert.
Oh, I'm sorry, Rosie. I don't suppose a generous tip will make things up.
Albert, just take your briefcase and go down to that train before any of the reporters talk to Conrad alone. You know what happened the last time.
I can't, Rosie. I've got to wait here for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you told her about dissolving Amulu?
I couldn't. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Lou, 6 years ago, he was hit on 181st Street and Broadway by a loaded beer truck.
Yeah.
Do you suppose that's Mama?
It's either her or the all clear.
Yahoo, Sammy.
Mama.
Oh.
Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, I'm just a little faint from the subway.
The subway, Mama, I told you to take the taxi.
Taxis? What do I need with taxis? I'll leave the taxis to my successful son. Hey, Mother can ride in a crowded, dirty subway full of foreign people that wouldn't give up their seat if their life depended on it. But what's the difference? A mother's lower than dirt nowadays. Here's the money I saved from not taking the taxi. Buy some candy with it. Oh, she.
Mama, you know Rose Alvarez from the office.
Oh, this is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez. Rose, what happened? You had a sudden shock or something?
Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll go see if Conrad's here.
Oh, by all means, Miss Alvarez. Look at her, Sonny. How nicely she looks. It's say wonder to me some old man hasn't snatched her off. A personal nature with brains and a few dollars. Oh, what a catch you'll be for the convalescent. Goodbye, Rose.
Bye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Mama, what I wanted to talk to you is what about Rosie? Maybe you better sit.
Why? I know my sonny. He loves his mama. He isn't going to say anything that would break her heart. Now, what about Rose?
Well, Mama, it's about Lou, too.
Lou? Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage that consumed faithfully for 32 years? Now, what about Lou?
Well, Mama, Rose thinks, and I agree, that I should give up Alvin, Lou. Mama, what's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. You just killed me, that's all. Lou, I'm coming. I'm on my way up.
Mama, it's just that Rose thought, here's the money, Mama. Take a taxi. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing's too crowded for a mother. I'll take the subway during the rush hour. That's the worst time. Wait! How many blocks is it after all? Only 107? I'll walk.
Mama!
Enjoy yourself, son. Wear your heavy coat. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money in your pocket. And eat a hot lunch.
Albert, I thought you were going to break it to him gently.
Well, as a matter of fact, Rosie, I couldn't tell her at all. I mean, she was so upset about my leaving, I thought I'd better wait.
You mean you didn't tell her?
He's coming! Conrad Bird, he's coming! Come on, Rosie. Conrad's coming. We can't let him talk to us as close as hell.
Albert,
later, Rosie, later.
Sing! We love you, Conrad. We love you, Conrad. I love you, Conrad.
shirt. He's been accepted to the armed forces. Say, Mr. Peterson, he cried eagerly. He's supposed to get assigned to the front line trenches. That will be sure to give me one of those dirty cherries.
Albert!
Oh, who's ever dirty this time?
Cover bread is just a fling. The steady is forever.
All thoughts of a nosebleed have suddenly vanished.
You were slid to where, Hugo. Karma bread is just a fling. The study is forever.
You're dizzy and faint. And that boy is me! You hear that, lady? That boy is me! Yeah!
And day you'll fly down. This is what life is all about. You need someone home.
Thank you.
enjoy his eggs. But I'm sure he won't mind if we just start clearing away some of these other things. I know the house is a big hectic this morning, but Camp's gone through a lot of trouble to make a special breakfast for Mr. Conrad Birdie. And I want to show the New York people we know how to treat a national figure here in Sweet Apple. I mean, it really doesn't mean that much to me personally, but for Camp's sake, I... There you are, dear. All done. Did you like it? No? You just hurry along.
Doris, I am not budging from this table till I get my coffee, smoke my cigarette, and read my paper.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. I didn't have time to make your coffee this morning. Would you like a nice warm 7-Up?
Morning, Pa. Here's your paper. I hope you don't mind if I tell a few stories about Conrad.
I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I have extended the privilege of self-determination to both the woman I have married and the children I have sired. No one has been denied for reason of age, sex, or political affiliations, and open covenants have been openly arrived. Last night, I gave up my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as Fats. Phone calls were made on my phone to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. Outside of my window, 3 Harpy Street,
"We love you, Conrad!"
4,323 times. I have just lost 2 Fridays. Gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament has been dissolved, Magna Carta has been revoked, and Nero is back in town. And you don't offer Nipper a warm 7-Up.
Mr. McAfee, I hope you won't mind keeping off the phone for a few minutes. We're expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Perfectly all right. I'll go out and burn Rome.
Nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad to be here, that's all.
He's coming, he's coming.
He's coming! Mother, you call the kids, I'll get the eggs!
Girls, hurry up if you want to see him eat!
Here we are, Kim!
I'm sorry, Doris, but we just had to come too. We'll send Kylie back here.
Here he is.
Call me for lunch.
Hey, Fats.
Now, Doris, look here. About that boy.
He's just shy, that's all.
I mean, Kim is only 15, and I don't want her.
Please, Daddy, not in front of everybody. Or so that we've gotta go.
He's only 15, and I don't want her.
Tell her, Pa.
You shut up! Better not.
That boy is our guest, and you have no right.
She was only 15, and I don't want her.
But, Dad...
Will you leave me alone?
Mr. and Mrs. McAfee? Kim? Randolph? Is this the one you want 75 million Americans to see you?
What are you talking about?
You're all going to be on television with Conrad.
On television?
That's right. I just got the confirmation from New York. From Ed Sullivan himself.
Ed Sullivan? You mean, we're gonna be on the Ed Sullivan Show?
That's right, they're gonna cut in on Sweet Apples this Sunday at 8:05, and you're all gonna be on. That's why I beg you to put aside all petty differences to that great audience out there. You're an American dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that dream. Yeah, on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Ed Sullivan!
Me and McAfee appearing with
Ed Sullivan. Ed
there's something I need to talk to you about.
Of course, it's been used as a movie house for the past 30 years, but I think it'll be fine for the TV show.
It'll be swell. Now, what I wanted to say was...
We're shutting down the cameras and lights today and whatever costumes we need.
Rose, I'm sure everything will be great. Now, you just forget about the Ed Sullivan Show for 1 minute and come into my office. There's something very important I need to talk to you about. About you and I, Rose.
You and me, English teacher?
Rose, I'm serious. Being away from New York has made me see all different types of things in a new way. That's why I want you to know I wrote Mama and told her no matter what happens, I decided to give up Almaloo.
Albert, you didn't!
Rosie, I did. I wrote her the day he left, which leaves her 3 days and 3 nights to get in touch with me. And so far, not one word. If you ask me, she's gotten over the whole thing by now. Okay. Come in.
3 days! And 3 nights on a tri-way bus. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother. And for a mother, a tri-way bus is good enough.
Mama, what are you doing here?
Oh, you suppose I wouldn't come? A mother gets a letter, obviously written under the influences of drugs. And she should stay at home. Hey, don't touch it. This is only a mother's tears. Dear Mom, this is to let you know that Amalu is dissolved. Your friend, Albert. Amalu is dissolved. Dissolve me. Who am I anyways? A sick old woman that probably won't last through the night. I just want one simple stone with one word carved into it. Albert's mother. And don't bother hiring a limousine to my final resting place. I'll walk.
Mama!
And tell that Spanish friend of yours, she's not knowing what she has done.
Mama, Rosie's right here.
This is Rose Alvarez. Rose Alvarez. Pretty little Rose Alvarez. Rose, you look like Margot when they took you off of the Shangri-La. Sonny, for her own sake, send her back to Tibet. And don't worry about a secretary, no. It just so happens I met one on the bus. A perfect secretary. She was gonna get off in Akron, only I persuaded her to get off here. Sonny, say hello to Gloria Rasputin.
Well, when you have all those releases to get out, and she could do them, unless it makes any difference to you, Rose.
Well, why would it make any difference to me?
Atta girl, Rosie. You just stay there and keep working. I'll go along with Miss Raspberry.
Oh, I'll find you a type fighter.
Do you use the touch system?
Whenever it's possible. I could kill him. I could just kill him.
And now, the young man we've all been waiting to see. As you know, in just about 14 hours, he's off to play a very special engagement. Before he goes, he wants to leave one lucky lady with one last kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, we take you to Sweet Apple, Ohio, with a typical American family. Mr. and Mrs. McAfee are gathered to bid farewell to a typical American soldier. Comrade Birdie!
Where's the head?
Last kiss, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this. It never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss.
Oh, one more time, oh baby, one more time. It really is sublime. Oh honey, so sublime. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss.
I'm done with you. That's right, I'm done with you. From now on, it's just gonna be me. up with a mama clutching, aspirin splitting, 6-foot tower of jello. What did I ever see in him? How could I ever get involved that way? Now that it's over, I can smile and say, what did I ever see in him? Boy, I was way out on a limb. Now that I'm safely on the ground again, now that my senses have been found,
can be like that.
Every one of them. Except maybe Albert Schweizer. And I'm not his type. Oh, they're all the same. From puberty to senility, Benedict Arnold to Mussolini.
I never understood why Ingrid Bergman married him in the first place.
Egotistical, selfish human beasts.
And what are poor women to do, Miss Alvarez?
Use them. Let them be our playthings while we live. We'll sip from the cup of life, mix the potion full strong, and drain it to the dregs. How do you like them apples, Mr. Peterson?
Do we need them? No, we don't. Do we want them? No, we don't. Will we need them?
No, we won't. Tell me, what did I say that for?
What did we ever see in them? How could we ever think that they were nice? Take it from us, we paid an awful price.
Hugo, what did I ever see in him? He's as bad as Mr. Peterson, if not worse. Miss Alvarez, I'm coming with you.
Kim, don't be ridiculous. You're only 15.
Julia was 14 when she left home.
And look what happened to her. Now look, Kim, why don't you just go back to bed?
It's too late for cookies. I want to live. We'll drink, we'll help each other with our potion.
Time, Albert. I'm all right, and I don't feel like getting into bed, so can you leave me alone?
Conrad, be reasonable. You just had a severe shock. The best thing to do is go upstairs and... There she is, the traitor who stabbed me in the heart when my back was turned.
Get out of my way, Albert.
Be careful, Sonny. She may be armed.
I can handle her, Mama. You go upstairs, make sure Conrad gets into bed.
Wait for me, Conrad. I'll make you a nice hot cup of tea.
The last time, will you let me by? I'm going on the town tonight, and I don't want to waste another minute.
Not until I have my say, Rosie. I just want to let you know that thanks to Mama's quick thinking, the kiss will take place after all. Tomorrow morning at the train station just before Conrad leaves. So it looks like you failed, as anyone must fail who tries to bust Al Peterson, one of the giants, the titans, one of the King Kongs of the music industry.
What did I ever see in him? How could I ever think that he was nice? Take it from me, I paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken heart.
And that power builder, Uncle Office!
Out of my way! Frocked English teacher!
What did I ever see in him?
Rosie! Back. Can you hear me? This is King Kong calling, Rosie. Oh, Rosie, please. And I don't care how much you beg and plead, Mrs. Irish. I do hear an Emily. And not only do I accept your resignation, but furthermore, you are fired. And one more thing, Sticks and stones will break my bones, but words will never hurt me. You big rat! I'm sorry. Hello, this is Albert J. Peterson. No, Miss Alvarez is no longer with us. That's right.
Miss Alvarez, wait for me, I'm coming.
Where do you think you're going, young lady?
With Rosie, to try and dip the dragon's sip full of hearty carp and creamy cup. To live!
Upstairs.
But Daddy!
I said upstairs. Do you hear me? I said upstairs.
Miss Alvarez was right. You're all the same. From Pyramid to Mussolini!
What's that? You dare say puberty in front of your father? Not to mention Mussolini? Doris, sweep up his parents. I'm not a woman. There are a few things I didn't want to hear in this house. Puberty was the first. Mussolini was the second. Now look here, Mr. Lewis. No greaser and porter can bulldoze me. I happen to be Albert J. Peterson, and you can put that in any paper you represent. It's not a paper, it's a magazine. Your name's not Mr. Lewis, it's Mr. Lewis. Rosie, I need you!
Sally boy, where are you going?
No worries, Mama. It was kind of stuffy, and to look for Rosie, Mama. I love her and I want her back.
Oh, is that all? I thought it was something more serious. Oh, by all means, find your lady of Spain and bring her back here. Oh, and when you come back, be sure to stop by the kitchen, get my head out of the oven, and turn off the gas.
Mama!
It's a strange house. I wouldn't want to run up a bill.
Mama, I've had enough of this. Don't you see what's happened? The poor girl's gone out to make up for all the years she's wasted on me. Who knows at what low dive she's in at this very moment.
Oh, Sonny, you're right. I'll help you find her. But maybe first, I might have to give you a message from Conrad first.
What message?
Oh, nothing, sweetheart, darling. Only he said that he was going out tonight and he doesn't think if he'll make it in time tonight to kiss Kim tomorrow.
Mama, why didn't you tell me about this before?
Oh, I tried to, sweetheart, darling, but you kept bringing up a certain party at the south of the border.
I don't know what's wrong with him. He knows how important this is to me. Conrad! Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy, I'm coming. And before you start, Albert, I wanted to let you know, I'm tired of getting up at 9 every morning, having people watch me when I eat, letting little kids poke me in the eye. I want to go out, have some fun, meet a couple of young chicks. Don't you understand, Albert? I am tense.
Mama, let us stand and do something.
Conrad, darling, did you ever think of terms of a more mature woman?
Man, I hope I never get that tense. Now listen, buddy boy. Last night before I go out to the army, and I'm telling you this one time, I am going out.
You can't go anywhere. It says so on your contract. Mama, give me my contract. Give me my. Never mind, I'll get it. Conrad, you stay here.
Conrad?
There are chicks just ripe for some kissing. And I mean to kiss me a few. Man, those chicks. Don't know what they're missing. There's such a lot of living to do. Sizzling steaks all ready for tasting. And there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Gotta move, this time is wasted. Such a lot of living. See everything for you and me. town?
Well, there's the church basement and the sweet shop, and the older kids go to the ice house.
What's at the ice house?
Well, it just so happens, Miss Birdie. The ice house is where people go when they want to be alone.
Aren't you the chick I'm supposed to kiss?
I'm not a chick. I'm a fully grown woman. Now, it seems to be treated as such. As a matter of fact, I'm leaving home.
Now you're talking, chick. We got a lot of room in here.
Motorboat races and moonlight swims and loop de loops. I'm doing the only thing reasonable I can do. Drink myself to death.
Moonlight swims, motorboat races, loop de loop. Oh my God!
Oh, Mr. McAfee, you haven't seen Conrad, have you?
No, but I intend on seeing him. And when I do, if you have a message for him to deliver to him, I'll be glad to deliver it. Right after I shoot him!
Shoot him! Rosie! I've got to find Rosie!
Dear, what are you talking about? You know you don't have a gun!
There's that Daisy Arbright from the garage!
That's fine!
You shut up! I wonder where I can my beanies this day.
Anyway, dear, it's broken.
Well, give me anything. My daughter is not loop-de-looping with the fiend. Give me a water gun. Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids who can understand anything they say. Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful oafs. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy loafers. And while we're on the subject, kids, you can talk and talk to your face turns blue. Kids, but they still do just what they want to do. Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids today? Kids. I don't mind the moonlight swims. It's the loop-de-loop that hurts. Kids. Why don't they lower the draft age to about 11? Kids. I didn't know what puberty was until I was almost past it. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy, loafers. And while we're on the subject, kids, they are just impossible to control. Kids.
out for clothes and they're rock and roll.
Why can't they dance like we did in a romantic way?
Hey, Pop, here's my pea shooter.
Pea shooter? What could the... Give it to me. What's the matter with kids today?
Double rocks on the scotch. Put actual rocks in it this time. Can I get a vodka Malton?
How old are you?
32. 32.
Get out!
How about a beer?
Out!
Can I stay here with an empty glass of wine?
Beat it!
I demand to see the manager.
Where's Mod? I'm Mod. Charles F. Mod. And if you're not out of here in a minute, I'll grab you by the neck and I'll take you out.
Okay, I'm going.
It's the last time I drink in this place.
Double bourbon, scotch on the side, no ice, and a cherry in it. Make that two cherries and bring on the dancing boys. Alvarez is the name, but I want you to call me Spanish Rose.
Spanish Rose?
See?
Get out!
Now, wait a minute. You can't throw me out. I'm an American citizen, and it's my constitutional right to have a drink here if I so choose, and get loaded here if I so choose, and do any manner of wild and trashy things here if I so choose. This is Spanish Rose's coming out party, and when I say coming out, I mean coming out!
That means there's a man involved.
No. Mama's boy. She hates me.
Mama's boys, mamas always do. So what's the problem?
I'm just a Spanish tamale, according to May. Right off the boat from the tropics far, far away. Which is kind of funny, since where I come from is... Allentown, PA! Spanish? Okay, May, I'll be Spanish right after I marry Alberta. I'll be the toast of Chichicostenango, and all day long my castanets will click. I'll hide behind my fan into the tango. I'll be so Spanish it will make you sick. The taco and the enchilada. I'll drink tequila till I feel no pain. The only song I'll sing will be Granada. I'll be more Espanol than Abby Lane. So call me the wild Spanish rose.
cha-cha in the nicest compliments. You'll have a little mustache and sombrero. I am some Latin lover from the Bronx. Not British, not Swedish, not Yiddish, but Spanish
rose.
Yeah.
Wire. Fidel Castro, someone named Peterson wants to talk to you.
You tell that weasley little rat that I'm not here.
That proves she's there. Who else would know a weasley little rat?
What?
Rosie, I've got to talk to you. It's about Conrad.
And furthermore, even if I was this Rose, which I am not, the only thing that would certainly make me hang up is any mention of anybody named Conrad.
No, Rose, please don't hang up. I want to mention Conrad. We can talk about anything you want. About you and I, you and me, anything. Oh, Rosie, please.
Talk to me.
Thank you.
Now, before the secretary reads the minutes of last week's meeting, I would like to bring up a topic that I'm sure is on everybody's minds tonight, right? Well,
can I ask for a favor? Can you go in there and give me a grain of alcohol to go, please?
Not for $1 million!
My whole life is passing before me! I can't get a drink! Kim's run off with Conrad!
Kim and Conrad? The Ice House? Albert! I've got to phone Albert! You go, you stay right here. Now, fellas, wait a minute.
Here it is. Mott's roadside retreat. I'm coming, Rosie. Hurry, Mama.
I don't know why you have to go running around all night looking for somebody that will be better not to find in the first place. If you listen to me, Sonny boy, you'll come home and have a nice cup of potassium.
Mama, I told you I'm not coming home till I find Rosie. Now, if you want to go home, that's fine with me. In fact, why don't you go home, Mama?
What did you say, sweetheart, darling?
I said, why don't you go home, Mama?
Would you mind repeating that to me? Sunshine of my existence?
I said go home, Mama. I don't need you any longer.
So, it has come at last. At last it has come. The day I knew would come at last has come at last. My sunny boy doesn't need me any longer. Well, what are you waiting for? Get rid of me! throw me out with the used grapefruits and the empty cans of tuna fish. And don't bother putting a lid on it now. Leave it open so 100,000 pussycats can walk all over a mother. Who bronzed your baby shoes? Pissed your every little bruise? Who picked your teddy socks up off the floor? You coughed and who was that? It's just too hard to bear. A mother doesn't matter anymore. With bunions on my feet, I trudge through snow and sleet to bring you licorice from the corner store. I sold my Tiffany love now. A mother doesn't matter anymore. There, I'm ready to go. And I don't want you to spend a cent. Fancy funerals are for rich people. Just wrap me up in a flag and dump me in the river on Mother's Day. And precious, by the way, the doctor called today. What I got's a condition. Yes, he sure. There's nothing they could do. I'll last a week or two. Because for a condition, there's no cure. That time you had the group who made you chicken soup. Cause a mother doesn't matter anymore. So everything is as it should be. A mother is sighing on top of a sanitation truck bound for the city dump. And his son is running around with a floozy who came looking for a good time but stayed to ruin an American woman's dream. Gave up nights of rest to rub Vicks on your chest. Who nursed her sonny boy till he was born? My life has been in pain. This country's down the drain. Cause a mother doesn't matter, no. A mother doesn't matter.
Are you still, Mama?
Yes, Sonny boy.
Good night, Mama.
Good night, Sonny boy.
My name's not Sonny boy.
You're just like your father. You'll marry anything.
Mr. Peterson, have you seen Conrad and Ken?
Ah, there, Mr. McAfee. Great pleasure to see you again. Unfortunately, I must inform you Conrad's affairs no longer interest me. And I'm looking for Rosie. Now tell her that. Conrad and Kim?
They were not together.
And if we don't find the clue, Mr. Peterson, I intend on calling the FBI. Who's the head of it now, dear? Is it Peter Lawford yet?
I'm sure everything will be fine.
Doris, Harry, have you seen Ursula?
Ursula?
Is she missing too?
Since 10 o'clock, and I've looked everywhere.
They're probably all down at the drugstore. Maybe had one of those gang wars.
Gang wars?
Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today. Kids,
who can understand anything they say?
Kids, they are so ridiculous and so immature. I don't see why anybody wants them.
Just you wait and see.
So
you'll be old enough to
kids with awful clothes and they're rock and roll.
Teenage delinquents,
what? They'd be like you were perfect in every way.
What's the matter with kids? Two kids, what the damn was wrong with these kids today? Kids, who could guess if they would turn out that way? Why can't they be like we were perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids?
What's the matter with kids?
What's the matter with kids today?
Hey, everybody! Shut up, Hugo! Here?
Hugo Peabody, what have you been drinking?
Milk, but it worked. I'm finally over the fact that my girls run off with Conrad
to the movies. Greg Doville tonight, playing down to Reno and Creed. Gosh, I'll never forget that great cast of Dolores del Rio.
And Gene Raymond.
And what a score.
I had forgotten that. Hey, Rio, flying down to Rio.
Rosie, where you been? I've been looking for you all night, Rosie. I've got great news for you, Rosie. I did it. I said, Mama, home. I'm a new man.
Albert, Conrad and Kim have gone to the ice house.
The ice house?
The ice house?
Well, here we are, Conrad. This is the ice house. Fun, isn't it? Of course. We have been here as many times as I have. You know, I've been here with just everybody. Ursula, Deborah Sue, the Girl Scouts, Conrad, he's a bit nervous. You're trembling. You know, just because you're a few years younger than I am, I hope it doesn't make you feel uncomfortable. I'm 27, or 28, you know, one of the two. So you see, I really got the score. Oh, there you are, you sanctuous one. We've been looking for you everywhere.
That is great. How am I late?
Well, you don't understand. We're coming with you. You said it yourself. We've got a lot of living to do.
Now, wait a minute.
We'll never go home. We'll follow you till the end of the area. Moonlight swim, motorboat races, loop the loop. Yeah!
But of course! That stuff really isn't as good as I made it up to be.
We can start right now. Yeah. Yeah.
There he is, the praise group. Well now, what do you have to say for yourself?
Thank God.
Hey, buddy. Good old Hugo. Again.
Hugo, darling. You're just in time. I can't see what humiliation I've been made to suffer.
That's all I need to hear.
McAfee, I demand you release that boy. Mr. McAfee, this is Albert J. Peterson speaking.
Albert, let me handle this. Look, why don't you go back to the house and I'll go...
Rosie, I don't think you understand. I'm a new man. I told Mama goodbye.
Albert, you did it!
Rosie, I did. And the new Albert is going down to the courthouse to talk to the mayor. And I appreciate it. You met me down at the train station at 6:30 sharp when I intended to be there with Conrad. And Rosie, did I ever tell you I love you?
Not yet, Albert.
Well, I do.
It's gonna be such a wonderful life. I'm gonna be Mrs. Peterson. Mrs. Albert Peterson. Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson.
Oh, Rosie, nothing can stop you now.
Heart-to-heart with an old friend.
I'll always have time to talk to the woman whom by tomorrow I'll be able to call.
Don't say it, Rose.
I'll be able to call Mother.
It's the cruelest word I've ever heard. To think I'll live to see the day I have relatives in El Salvador.
Not to mention Guatemala, Brazil, Chile, Uruguay, and Chichicostenango. And as soon as Albert and I are married, I'm gonna stick a rose in my teeth, sit in front of my adobe hood on Central Park West, and sell tortillas. Adios, mama.
Adios, Rosita.
Call me, Mrs. Peterson.
Now look, Albert.
I don't have any time for your nonsense. It took every cent I had to bail you out, and I don't want to see you till you're out of state. Now get on board.
Albert, whether you pay me what I was guaranteed or not, you've got a contract with me for life.
Carl, what are you saying?
Here is a napkin that I signed my name to. Just fill in whatever you like.
Hello, Albert.
Mama.
Don't worry, I know about you too.
Bruce! You look good for a change.
Oh, don't worry. She can keep them, all seven of them, when the train passes over me.
Mama, get up and get on that train. I have no time for nonsense. Mr. Brady, he is not in that jail.
Mr. McAfee, I haven't seen Conrad all night. I'm just down here to say goodbye to Rosie.
Mr. Peterson.
Now, dear, there's no reason to get excited. Everything's here is good. Kimmy Hugo are back together. As a matter of fact, the sweetest thing happened. Hugo proposed to Kim and she accepted. What's wrong, dear?
Nothing, dear. Nothing. I'll just sell the house now. My life is over. We're going into a home.
Albert! Albert, the train is leaving. Hop on.
Goodbye, Conrad.
Albert!
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you.
It left at 6:25.
Albert, you told me to be here at 6:30.
With Conrad.
At 6:30 sharp, I know because...
And Mama.
Albert, you wanted us to miss that train.
Well, that's the reason, Rose. Why get on a train to New York when we've got tickets to Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
Oh, what's in Pumpkin Falls, Iowa?
An opening in the teaching staff at Pumpkin Falls Junior High. I read in this morning's paper, they want someone to teach English and domestic science. And I hope you brought your documents, Rose. Because they prefer the applicant to be married.
Oh, Albert!
Rosie, did I ever tell you that's the most beautiful name in the world? I was never crazy for flowers. I confess that nothing left me colder. I could watch a daisy for hours, and all I feel was several hours older. Lilacs and lilies, any bloom you please. All that they did was make me shrug or sneeze, but now I love each blossom that I see. For a lovely little rose loves me. Now my life is rosy. Since I found my rose. So cozy by a fire.
from me. There's one rose sweeter than any that grows, and that's my rose to me. I'm so glad you chose me. Life is one sweet, beautiful song to me. Now my life is rose. Life is one sweet, beautiful song.